In this demonstration, we're going to show a migration from OpenText Content Server 10 to SharePoint and OneDrive. First, we will extract the data from the source system OpenText Content Server 10 using our migration tool and store this data in our unified data model database, Mongo DB. After the extraction, we will analyze and transform the data using Xillio Insights. We are going to show the dashboards that we use to determine the business rules. Once those are set, we can apply the transformations in our UDM database. And afterwards, we're going to load everything into SharePoint. On the left side of the screen, you can see the Xil IDE. This is the software we use for the entire migration. In this demo, we're going to run the extract, transform, and load functions, which we select here. And on the right side of the screen, you can see the user interface for OpenText Content Server with some folders and files. We browse through it and see regular folders and documents, but also compound documents, projects, and workflows. Different content types which are specific to OpenText, but we want to take with us to SharePoint. Here we can also find personal workspace with some folders, files, and we also see the tasks from the workflows that are assigned to this user. We want to migrate this content to the OneDrive for this particular user. So now we're ready to start the extraction by pressing the play button. The console log shows feedback on the extraction. When we go to our database, we see that there is a new collection with documents that is being filled as we speak. It's nicely arranged with decorators. All the information we extract is stored in the original folder, and the modify folder is where we can change things if that is needed for the migrations. There's also a migration folder where every change is logged. Next up is the analysis of the extracted data, for which we use Xillio Insights. This is the first dashboard of Xillio Insight that gives a general overview of the 92 documents we have extracted. We click on file categories to see what kind of documents we have. Their creation date. The extensions, and information about the size of the folders and where all these documents live. Another cool feature of Insights is the possibility to filter. For instance, only view the text files. For this demo, we decided not to migrate these text files. This is our first business rule. We also see that the extracted data contains some executables, JavaScript files in this case, which is the second business rule, no executables. The next dashboard we'd like to show you is the duplicate dashboard. That shows all the duplicates, their location, duplicates in the same folder, and the total size of the duplicates, a perfect starting point to search for unnecessary content. This dashboard shows the active content. You can see, for example, when documents were last accessed. In this dashboard, you can filter on documents that haven't been accessed for a certain amount of time. This dashboard gives information about the folders. We see that there are 30 folders in total, and here we can see which ones have children and which are empty. These are the most frequent folder names in our data set, and right now we're going to see which ones are empty. We excluded these from the migration, our third business rule. We also have different versions in our dataset, so we can see which documents are versioned. We showed you the workflows inside of the OpenText Content Server 10. We can see that there are three workflows. Those three workflows have been initiated 9 times and a total of 52 steps. And we can also see all the attached documents to each instance. We can filter on one of the workflows and zoom in on one of the instances to see extra data about this step of the workflow instance. On On the right side of the dashboards, we can also filter on all the documents attached to a workflow or instance. The Audits dashboards gives an overview of the entire audit trail of the system, 17,000 in total. On the right, you can see all the different events, and if you click on them, you can see how many times they happened, and the different performers. We can also zoom in on a specific document to see its entire audit trail. The business rules we created based on Xillio Insights are: first, no text files to the target system. Second, no executables to the target system. Third, no empty folders to the target system. Now, we will run the transformation script so all data is ready to move to the target system. While it is running, the database on the right side is being updated in real time. It's time for the final step of the migration, the load. We will use the Xil IDE again to start on the import. On the right side, you can see that folders and documents are being created in SharePoint Online. Let's take a look at the workflows. We see there's a workflow application with different instances and the related documents. Let's also take a look at the OneDrive, which was the personal workspace in OpenText. All files and folders have been migrated to this person's OneDrive. And finally, you can see the report of the migration in Excel. It shows information about the entire ETL process of a single document, the source path before the extract, whether or not a folder or document was migrated, to which department, and also the new target path in SharePoint.